Hi, everyone. Aaron here for Zolotech, and macOS Big Sur is the next big release for macOS, bringing us to macOS 11, but I wanted to share with you the top five best features, or at least that I've seen so far. And so the first thing is extremely simple, and if you miss that startup sound from Mac, you can bring it back in previous versions, but Apple eliminated it some time ago. So if you want to hear this sound, Apple has enabled this within your system preferences by going to Sound and then Play Sound on Startup. You can, of course, turn this off or turn it back on if it's already turned off, but now they've given us this option, and I think this is something that's very nice that many of us really missed and is nostalgic. And of course, if it's annoying, turn it off. But I think it's a great feature that people overlooked in this particular update, and so I wanted to point that out. Now, the next thing is Safari. Now, I know a lot of people prefer Chrome or Firefox or maybe another browser as well, maybe even Microsoft's new Edge browser. But Safari with macOS Big Sur is a major update that has a lot to offer. It should be 50% faster than other competitors, according to Apple, and it has a lot of features. You can see I have a desktop background here. We can change it with these buttons on the left. We'll just switch between different pictures. We can select whatever we'd like. And so you can switch to, maybe we want to switch to the catalog. Catalina Shoreline. Now we've got that. You could switch it to your family or whatever you'd like. It gives us a privacy report on all the different trackers that we've been prevented from being tracked by from different websites. And so I've checked out my own website here where I just use Google Analytics to see who's visiting. But many sites have a lot of different trackers. And so you have websites that are tracking, and then also here are the trackers specifically. So you'll see 66% that contacted trackers, which is pretty high and not surprising these days. And you have other things as well, such as your reading list or other things from handoff from different Macs or different devices. So it's super nice and really fast, but it has a couple extra features built in that I really like. One of them is Translate. So if we go to Peugeot.fr in France, I can't read this personally because I don't speak French. So let's translate it to English so I can see what's going on here. So it says offers at the moment, enjoy our offers of the moment, go further in your project. So we can view any website that might be in a different language. Apple will translate it on the fly on the device so you can read it, or you can change it to a different language if you prefer something else. Any supported language should work. So it has all of that built in along with all this privacy, and you'll see it just blocked 41 trackers. So that's super convenient to have that built in. And of course it has extensions now too that are super secure. So you'll have extensions that pop up in the App Store and will be available to macOS Big Sur. So you can have all sorts of different extensions. So this will be really nice once it's out for everyone to use, or it might be out by the time you're watching this. But if you want this kind of privacy throughout your Mac, not just with your web browser, that's where today's sponsor comes in, Intego Software, where they have Virus Barrier in their suite of programs called X9. And so as you can see here, it says your Mac is not safe, turn on real-time scanning. So you can adjust your settings for that, keep it on, place files in quarantine, attempt to repair them. And it's a simple way to keep everything safe. Not only your browsing within Safari or Chrome or whatever you're using, but you can schedule scans as well. And so if you want to scan your Mac, you can do that. If you have an iPhone plugged in, you can scan that. And then once you find something, you can quarantine it, delete it, and enable that real-time scanner if you want to use it. And it keeps up to date regularly. So you can see the last definition update was a couple days ago. So we should be good to go. Now, if you're looking for a good virus program, I would recommend Virus Barrier, or at least trying their free trial. And if it's something you like and it works for you, along with all of their other software, Personal Backup, Washing Machine, Net Barrier, and Content Barrier, be sure to try those out with their free trial, and be sure to click the link in the description below for 50% off. Now, the third great feature with macOS Big Sur is Control Center. We've had this on iPads and iPhones for quite some time. We can control everything from the keyboard brightness if you're on a MacBook to sound and everything else. And if you want to create a shortcut, you can just drag it up here to the top. And now you also have a way to turn dark mode on or off. You can switch it on the fly or change it back if you don't want it. So it takes a little bit here. There's a little bit of a delay, but you'll see it switches and we're good to go. We have a quick way to access all of our settings. And I think it's a really nice way to access everything. It's kind of long overdue, and I'm glad they added it. Now, another huge feature that's been updated using all new code is Messages. Now, Messages has been completely rewritten, not only with new emoji, but also the effects we expect on our iPhone, such as message effects or Memoji stickers. So if you click on Memoji stickers, it takes a moment, and then we have our stickers. So we can select whatever we want. We want this one, and then we can send it and say, look at this. And then we can also include a message effect. And so we want balloons or whatever we'd like. We can send it, and then we'll have balloons with our new emoji stickers. So, or Memoji stickers, depending on what you're using. So we have all of the different things we'd like included, but we can also pin conversations. There's group enhancements and everything else. So if you want to pin something or a conversation, pin it, and it will always appear above this line. If I want to pin this one from my brother Zach, I can just pin it, and now it's above this line, always ready for me to use. And so we've got all of the same things we expect from iOS and iPadOS on macOS. And then finally, one of the major changes with macOS Big Sur is, of course, it is macOS 11, as you can see here. And this is currently a beta version, but you get the idea that this is macOS 11. It's a complete overhaul of the OS to make it ready for the new ARM-based or Apple Silicon-based Macs. And you can see all of the icons are different. And this is one of the most striking things to a lot of people. Some people love it, some people don't. All of these icons may not be finalized at this point, but one that particularly stands out is the battery icon. Hopefully they change this in the future, but you'll see everything's been rewritten from the ground up. It should be faster, hopefully a lot more stable than what we had before. And we should be pretty good with this version as far as speed and everything else. So there are a lot of other changes, such as updates to passwords and things. So if you're using Keychain, for example, Keychain will now let you know when you have a password that's been compromised. So that's a new feature built in, which I think is super helpful and all about security. macOS Big Sur is all about security. It will keep you safe. And in addition to Safari and macOS keeping you safe, be sure to check out Virus Barrier in the description below. Let me know what your favorite app or change is with macOS Big Sur. Some of these icons are great, some are not. Let me know what you like most about it in the comments below. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.